We have in the studio Cheta Nwanze, head of research at SBM Intelligence, and he'll be giving us his perspective on this and, of course, some other issues relating to the country today. Cheta, thanks so much for joining us today.
Thank you for having me.
Your perspective about the drama that played out last week at the National Assembly and this whole conversation about whether or not the National Assembly should reconvene. I think the latest we're hearing from the leadership is that everyone is not available. Some people have gone for the Hajj, and so it's really impractical to expect that they can reconvene. But your perspective on
It's unfortunate that we're playing this kind of theater, because that's what this is. It's not; these are not serious people, just playing drama with essentially the processes that should keep the country running. You have a situation where, as an example, the excuse that was given was because of the INEC budget. Can the INEC budget wait until the end of September when they are meant to reconvene? I think it can. However, given that it's supposed to be of high importance, it's fair enough to ask them to reconvene to consider it. But it became quickly clear that the main item on the agenda for at least certain groups was the impeachment of the leadership of the National Assembly, especially because of the defection drama. And that only ends up hitting the polity. We've now seen one of the big security chiefs first falling on his sword because of this whole thing. And we're going to see more things play out. I think the key thing is that certain elements within the ruling party, within the APC, want to remove the now defected Senate president because he's in an influential position and they don't want him there.
All right, we'll continue to see the drama, if you like, unfold as you put it.
Welcome to Shakespeare.
All right, but let's move on to another big issue, which is the fight against insurgency. And the Nigerian army recently uncovered an online platform used by the faction of Boko Haram to recruit new members. And beyond that, of course, I did mention the story earlier about the acting president instructing the Inspector General of Police to take action around SARS. Your perspective on security in Nigeria today, as we move into the elections, the various issues that you are seeing on the ground today?
Well, the security situation is terrifying, and that's putting it lightly. The discovery of the online platform by the Al-Banawi faction of Boko Haram to recruit new members is nothing surprising. At this point, we've still failed to tackle the root causes. We haven't gotten any major financier. We've not brought any major financier to book. And when you keep arresting or killing pawns in the game, pawns are easily replaced. We need to bring one big financier to book. We haven't done that.
What does this tell you about the claims, for instance, by the government that they've made significant progress with tackling Boko Haram? We're not seeing the, if you like, headline-catching attacks that we used to see a few years ago, even though we have seen a couple.
We've been seeing an escalation. And remember, on this very show some months back, I said that the Boko Haram thing was nowhere near over. What has happened is that we now have what I'll call better information management. We have better means to massage the information that is coming out. But the fact is that from a strategic perspective, we have given up large portions of raw Borno, for example, to Boko Haram and have concentrated on securing Maiduguri, Damboa.
So in other words, there are some parts of that state that
there are large parts pretty much considered to Boko Haram, large parts of the state. And then, of course, you can't forget the fact that just a few days ago, some soldiers mutinied when they tried to redeploy them. These tensions exist. The fact that a few weeks ago, quite a number of soldiers, and it was initially denied, but it became very clear that really happened. Quite a number of soldiers were killed in an attack. There are various factions of Boko Haram. We count at least three. And the military doesn't seem to have the best lead on it. Not because of the military's lack of capabilities, it must be said, but because the political will to do what needs to be done is not there. And then we still have issues of diversion of resources. A video was released by a soldier, and these are things that are quite worrying. A video was released by a soldier complaining about the conditions under which they are operating. That's not about military capability. That's about corruption within the hierarchy. Those problems still exist. Now, I think that the bigger conflict still remains the pastoral conflict in its various forms.
Incidentally, sorry to cut in again,
yeah.
We haven't been seeing as much reporting as we saw, say, two
again,
months ago.
And again, information management, you think that's massaging headlines again? And all of that. So, just yesterday in Puma, in Benue State, three people were killed. The issues, incidents still happen on a consistent basis in Taraba State. And two, 3 days ago, there was a meeting in Plateau State where brokered by the NSCDC, where some groups came together, smiled for the cameras. But the key thing that is missing in that is justice. We still have issues in Zamfara. So, and then the Abuja-Kaduna road is still more or less a no-go zone. So these issues still exist. The fact that they've probably moved to second or third place on the headlines because of the theater happening in Abuja is just incidental. Fact is, these things are still there,
right.
And we still need to really watch out for them, because in some places the cost of moving goods from place to place has gone up astronomically.
But let's examine the build-up to next year's elections and 4 years ago, because we had similar concerns and Boko Haram was a big challenge, and there appeared to be an escalation of attacks at the time. But the elections came and went relatively peacefully. Do you think that there's a good chance that we can see a similar outcome this time, or do you think there are more causes for concern this time around?
The possibility exists. For me, what worries me more about the 2019 elections is not the security issues per se, but how the outcome will be accepted by various parties. Unlike 4 years ago, where there was a lot of noise raised, and that singular act by the former president of calling his challenger to concede victory basically deflated a lot of the tension. Will we have such a moment of magnanimity this time around? That remains to be seen. As in, will whoever loses the election in 2019 be gracious enough to concede? That will determine how bad things get.
But in the build-up, you think that we can still manage
in the build-up somehow? We may just manage. I think over the next 2 months, the key events will be the PDP convention.
Right.
There are quite a number of people who are interested in the tickets. If they manage to do the convention and within themselves all accept whoever emerges and line up behind the person, it will bring down tension levels a bit,
yeah.
And then we will now have the inter-party tension. But if they do not, well, while we'll have the intra-party tension within PDP, it will guarantee President Buhari a second term.